Now we'll take a look at factoring perfect square trinomials. There is a special formula to factor perfect square trinomials, but looking at these first two examples, my suggestion is to factor these as we normally would when a is equal to 1. So for x squared plus 12x plus 36, since there are no common factors, if this factors, it's going to factor into two binomials. The first positions of the binomial factors will come from the factors of x squared, which would be x and x. And now we want the factors of c that add to b, or the factors of positive 36 that add to positive 12. Notice that 36 is a perfect square since 6 times 6 is equal to 36. But also notice that 6 plus 6 is equal to 12. So the two factors we need are positive 6 and positive 6. So we have x plus 6 and x plus 6. And notice that we have two equal factors, which means we can rewrite this as the quantity x plus 6 squared, which is the reason why this is called a perfect square trinomial. Now looking at our second example, we'll apply the same strategy. Again, there are no common factors here. So if this does factor, it'll factor into two binomials. The first positions are the factors of x squared, which would be x and x. And now we want the factors of positive 64 that add to negative 16. Again, notice that 64 is a perfect square because 8 times 8 is equal to 64. But notice that 8 plus 8 is equal to positive 16, and we want a sum of negative 16. So instead of using positive 8 and positive 8, we'll use negative 8 and negative 8. Remember, a negative times a negative is positive, and then a negative 8 plus a negative 8 would equal negative 16, the sum that we want. So our factors are x minus 8 and x minus 8. Again, the trinomial factors into two equal factors. So we can write this in factored form as the quantity x minus 8 squared. Therefore, our trinomial is a perfect square trinomial. Now for these next two examples, notice how a is not equal to 1. But notice if it is a perfect square trinomial, the first term and the third term must be perfect squares. So looking at our next example, notice how 4x squared is a perfect square, and so is 9. We know this because 4x squared would be equal to 2x squared. And 9 is a perfect square because we can write this as 3 squared. So now let's go ahead and factor this as a perfect square trinomial, and then we'll check to see if it works. So we'll have two binomial factors. The first positions must come from the factors of 4x squared, so we'll use 2x and 2x. The second positions must come from the factors of 9. Let's go ahead and try 3 and 3. And then if it is a perfect square trinomial, we'll use the sign of the middle term, so these will both be subtraction. Now to check this, we really only have to check to make sure the sum of the inner product and the outer product does give us the middle term. Notice the inner product is negative 6x, the outer product is negative 6x, which would have a sum of negative 12x. So this is a perfect square trinomial, so we can rewrite this as the quantity 2x minus 3 squared. Notice how it does say here the middle term would be 2 times a times b, but this is a lot to remember, so I think as long as we check to make sure the first term and the last term are perfect squares, we can quickly check to make sure the inner product and outer product have a sum of the middle term. So looking at one more example, again notice how a is not equal to 1, there are no common factors, 16x squared is a perfect square, and so is 25. We know this because we can write 16x squared as 4x squared, and 25 is a perfect square because we can write this as 5 squared. So now we'll factor this into two binomials and see if it works. So the two factors of 16x squared that we're going to use are 4x and 4x. The factors of 25 we're going to use are 5 and 5. We use the sign of the middle term, so it's going to be plus here and plus here. And now we'll just check to make sure this works by checking the sum of the inner product and outer product. We have 20x here and we have 20x here, which does have a sum of 40x, so it works. Therefore, we have a perfect square trinomial. And we can write this as the quantity 4x plus 5 squared. As I've said before, I'm not a big fan of just memorizing formulas, but in this case, if we recognize that the first term and the third term are perfect squares, my suggestion is to go ahead and factor it as a perfect square trinomial, and then just check to make sure it works. I hope you found this helpful.